And welcome to the screening room. I'm Agent Simmons. Agent Edwards is on assignment in the Andromeda Galaxy, but he'll be back with us soon. Chris Hemsworth and Tessa Thompson last co-starred in the hit Marvel epic Thor Ragnarok, and they re-teamed to reboot the Men in Black franchise, Men in Black International. While this wacky sci-fi action comedy lacks the freshness of the previous entries, it retains the goofy spirit of the series. That may not be enough to satisfy fanboys, however. Shawn says, quote, there is no need for this movie to exist. Tessa Thompson and Chris Hemsworth work because they are Tessa Thompson and Chris Hemsworth. The story doesn't work because it's stupid, and director Gary F. Gray lazily collected a check. This franchise has long been dead. Guess this is the cinematic death certificate. Well, I liked it better. I've given it 3 out of 5 popcorn bags, and Shawn gives Men in Black International 1 popcorn bag. After a 19-year hiatus, Samuel L. Jackson returns as the bad you-know-what in Shaft. The original Shaft, Richard Roundtree, returns with newcomer Jesse T. Usher as 3 generations of tough guys battle a nasty drug lord. Shaft is rude and crude and plays almost like a cheap self-parody. I can't dig it. Shawn says this new version of Shaft is about as un-PC and as cool as it gets, way funnier than I would have imagined and completely entertaining. On a personal level, reminded me of my dad and uncles. I'll give it 2 popcorn bags. Shawn gives Shaft 3 popcorn bags. The comedy Late Night plays like a reworking of The Devil Wears Prada set in the world of late night TV. Emma Thompson plays an aging talk show host facing forced retirement. Mindy Kaling, who also wrote the screenplay, plays a wannabe comedy writer who invades the largely white male bastion of the writer's room. She battles sexism, ageism, and racism with her comic barbs. It's a bit too conventional for its own good, but those stars make it work. Shawn says, written by Mindy Kaling, I love that she attempts to address the women in the workforce, especially as a writer in a male-dominated industry, ageism in entertainment, but as a movie, it doesn't quite gel despite the best intentions. I'm giving it 3 popcorn bags, but guess what? Shawn's right there with me. 3 popcorn bags for Late Night. And art film icon Jim Jarmusch takes a low-key comic approach, even deadpan, I'd say, to the zombie drama with The Dead Don't Die. Bill Murray and Adam Driver lead the cast in the tale of a small town suffering from a living dead apocalypse. The cast and crew probably had a whole lot more fun making this self-referential movie than the audience while watching. It's for indie insiders only. 2 popcorn bags for me. You can see all of our reviews and interviews with Hollywood's biggest stars at fox4kc.com/screeningroom. Also, please give us a like. That's the Fox 4 Screening Room Facebook page for all of the inside movie scoop. And that's it for this week. Until next time, I'm Agent Simmons, and you will remember nothing.
Wow. That was so good.
You're amazing.
Very good.
It sounds like your performance was better than the new Men in Black movie.
According to Shawn, I would say that's probably true.
I'm still trying to figure out that Shaft comment. It reminds him of his uncle. And
you'll have to check with him on
dad.
That.
Okay.
Apparently.